Motivation. It's a huge problem, and it's a problem that's a lot larger than people want to accept. The kids don't care. Half my battle, about 80% of my work in my field, is just trying to get the kids to care about anything that I'm trying to get them to do. All right? One of the problems I have to deal with is the fact that, look, they don't see any incentive to actually seeing any potential benefit coming down the pipe later on. And so I want to build that for them. Which brings me to the universal truth. Everyone loves acknowledgement, and especially public acknowledgement. They like awards and feel like they're being rewarded. Look no further than network TV. You got the Grammys, you got the Oscars for forever, and most recently the athletes are in on it. They got the ESPY Awards. So my thoughts are, see look at those pictures I got. My thinking is, why not take this truth and apply it to the school setting? So introducing my idea, something I've been doing for the last 3 months with a lot of success. I invested 15 bucks with your help. I think we can impact a lot more. The Math Morrissey Awards. My name is Chris Morris, so therefore I said Morrissey Awards. Who knew it was going to work out? But they are character awards. They're not based on academics or metrics. All right? I want to highlight that they did some patience. I want to say, hey, this is the patient thing they did. Maybe they like the sleeping class. Well, he made it a whole day without sleeping. Let's award him. Let's say that's something that we want to build and instill into the kids. I want to give you one quick story before I go any further. When I was working this past March, there was a girl. We're going to call her DeShayla to protect the innocent. DeShayla wasn't liked by her classmates. In fact, she often annoyed them. Well, DeShayla was being DeShayla, and the other kids weren't really feeling very good about it. And I challenged these two other girls who were more popular, the pretty girls everyone followed. And I said, look, girls, I want y'all to talk to DeShayla. Next time she says something that rubs you the wrong way, I want you to look at her and say something nice. And they said, Mr. Morris, I ain't got nothing nice to say. And I said, you can find something. So, sure enough, 5 seconds later, DeShayla said something that was kind of and I looked at the girls and said, let's go. And they said, okay, DeShayla, we like your hair. DeShayla goes, oh, thanks. I said, do something else. They go, DeShayla, we like your shoes. I said, girls, that's pretty good. Can you say something about a person, you know? And they said, that's as good as we got, Mr. Morris. And I said, fair enough, let's start class. So we start class, and what was funny was, throughout the rest of the class, DeShayla would say something that rubbed everyone wrong, and the girls would yell, DeShayla, we like those nails you got. DeShayla, we like that shirt. DeShayla, we like this and that. And I thought it was funny, so I just let it keep going, and it seemed to be conducive. Well, fast forward to the end of that week, the same girls who were complimenting DeShayla for what she wore actually started to feel some motherly concern for her. DeShayla had a bug that was going around. She felt sick. One of the girls raised her hand and said, Mr. Morris, I really need, are you serious? Okay. They said, Mr. Morris, I really need to go to the bathroom and get a nice damp rag for DeShayla because she doesn't feel good. And my mom did that for me. I felt really bad. And I said, all right, go ahead and do it. She came back. Not only did she put a damp rag on DeShayla's forehead, she rubbed her back. And all of a sudden, she was like a mothering instinct. And I was like, this is unbelievable. Well, I gave her a Morrissey for that. That was pretty awesome. Fast forward 3 months later, I'm walking into the school cafeteria, and I see those popular girls and DeShayla all sitting at the same cafeteria, and I asked the girls, I said, hey, what's up with this? And they said, Mr. Morris, we've been letting her sit with our table for the last 3 months. And I gave them another Morrissey. And so that's really what it is. This is the Morrissey I gave to show concern for classmates and getting her a damp cloth when sick. They like outside. I said, the next outside lovely day, we're going to go outside. And we celebrated everybody together for one person's success. I work with, I think it's Sean. We work this Friday. She helped me out. This is what I want to do as a template for other teachers to adopt going into the future. I think we can all bring in and have this too. This is a certificate that I give that has ceremony music that goes along with it, so it really seems like you're getting an Oscar, right? And it comes with little rewards that come with it. So I've been doing like free homework, or I've been giving, hey, you get the snacks in class, little things, and the impact has been unbelievable. The kids love it, and their character has actually changed. I've watched this. I've seen gang members change their behavior around and do better on tests, but I gotta get a Morrissey. I'm like, all right, let's do it, you know? And so what I want to do, and your money is primarily being invested into rewards. We're going to kick it up a notch. At the end of 9 weeks, I want to give them iPads. I want to give them maybe an Xbox if that's what they're into. Whatever they like, I want to give them movie tickets, sporting events, lookout games. Whatever it is, I'm going to invest in it. One of my best friends, and I'm actually really proud of him, he plays baseball for the Houston Astros. I gave him all this gear, and I'm getting him on board. I really want people to invest and see the impact. We start in the classroom, and we're going to impact the city.